parking brake set. Light controls, check. Alternator, check.
Release the brakes. Let's do it.
There's really nothing like being in the sky. It's this feeling of just looking at the world and experiencing it from a different perspective.
College Park traffic, Warrior 434, 60 left downwind.
One of the biggest challenges that pilots face is the number of things that are going on in the cockpit.
All right, now give me a left turn.
You're tracking your airspeed, your altitude, all of the flight instruments, how the engine is doing. As more complexities emerge, stress increases for the pilot, especially when there might be a degraded visual condition. It's a lot easier for mistakes to happen.
Now the major developments late today in the Kobe Bryant helicopter crash investigation.
The veteran pilot may have been disoriented in
the
fog.
They say that he couldn't perceive up from down.
Divers today found the bodies of John Kennedy, his wife and her sister, in the wreckage of his plane.
Spatial disorientation.
Spatial disorientation.
According to the FAA, it causes 5 to 10% of all general aviation accidents, 90% of which are fatal.
Traditionally, pilots fly aircraft using their vision as well as their equilibrium. Now, sometimes there may be a discrepancy between what the pilot feels and what the instruments are indicating to the pilot. And this creates a dangerous scenario called spatial disorientation. What if we could use more senses in order to overcome this phenomena and increase the safety of flight?
We should test haptic and visual first.
Our lab's called Standard Reality Flight Simulation Control.
We start with a baseline, you use visual only, and you rely on the indicators in front of you.
Visuals take some time, like, to process what are you seeing, audio takes some time, what are you listening to, but haptics are perceived through our brains in a faster way than the other cues. So we tell the pilot how to fly using the sense of touch.
You have to stay within the inner core for the scoring time.
We start with the easy patterns and increase the difficulty based on the performance from the pilot. We do the first trials with vision.
Okay, ready.
And then we degrade the vision using goggles. And then we go with the blindfold.
You will not be seeing the screen. When we go to the haptic and audio, we are expecting you still be inside the inner core. After we do this experiment, we go over the simulators.
We try to create a very immersive flight simulation environment for pilot training.
So, what do you see now?
I'm in the cockpit and I have a heads-up display in front of me.
We have access to multiple flight simulators.
Right, motion base is on.
We can recreate a wide range of flight conditions.
In the clouds or at night or where there is no visual reference outside.
Now I have no visibility in this cloud. It's very disorienting without the environmental cues. I'm pretty much relying on the instruments as well as the audio and haptic cues.
Imagine that the aircraft is rolling to the right and it should not. Then the pilot will feel a haptic sensation on the left shoulder to indicate that they should be rolling back to the left. If the aircraft is banked pretty steeply to the right, then the sensation will be pretty strong.
I'm feeling haptic input now on my left shoulder, and it's more intense now. It's definitely helpful now that I can't see anything anymore. We use 3D audio cueing to deliver audio cues that also correspond to the same control input that has to be made. Now that I'm in this left bank, I have a really intense right cue on my right ear, so it's a really high frequency. The audio cues match the haptic cues pretty well with respect to intensity and frequency.
It was really surprising for us to see that the pilots actually reacted faster using haptics rather than vision only. Whenever they were flying at night or throughout the clouds, they relied on haptic feedback to hold attitude. And hearing from the pilot the fact that they weren't relying on vision anymore to fly was both surprising and particularly pleasing, because it meant that these ideas actually turned out to be useful.
We got it. We can fly by feel, just relying on our haptic feedback.
hopefully one day we'll be able to collaborate with the industry to actually make these ideas into reality and practical applications.
It's just incredible. We can do extraordinary things.